We're going to take a look at a micro video transmitter from AKKTEK, which you can see mounted right there. And this little kind of FPV pod backpack type thing I've set up. We'll take a look at that more in a minute. This is the actual product. It's the AKKTEK Nano 1 5.8 GHz 48 channel switchable video transmitter. It is 19 by 15 millimeters. There's a website if you want to check it out, akktek.com. I'll also put a link below the video. You get this little instruction manual in the package with it. You can see there's some more specs on the back here. Your input voltage range is 3.2 to 5.5 volts. There is a 0 milliwatt power setting. It says without interference. I guess they mean that's for if you're using it with a quad or whatever, you know, race quad or plane, whatever. And you're flying around some other people that are flying on 5.8 gigahertz, you can drop the power down to 0 milliwatt, so you don't interfere with them while you power your plane up on the ground and, you know, in close proximity to their receivers. I'm guessing you would still want to be on a different channel, but it's a nice feature if you want it. One thing I can already foresee is that it's going to be quite useful for range testing antennas and things like that, because I've already played around with it a little bit, and on the 0 milliwatt setting, just across the room, you start to get a weak video signal. So it's going to be quite handy for, you know, relative comparisons between different antennas and receivers, things like that. It supplies 5 volts to your camera, up to 300 milliamp hours max, milliamps, I'm sorry, or 0.3 amps. Your output power, besides that 0 milliwatt setting, you have an option for 25 milliwatts or 200 milliwatts. And you see at 3.7 volts, or from a 1S LiPo, it's going to pull 320 milliamps at 25 milliwatts, or 650 milliamps at 200 milliwatts. It does have a little IPX connector, IPEX. It's a little micro coaxial connector for the antenna, which is handy, so you can swap that out if you would like to do so. For now, I'm going to be using it with a little stock dipole that comes with it. You have they say it's a 5-pin port, which actually that's broken out into 2 connectors, which we'll take a look at in a bit. Dimensions, once again, is 19 by 15 millimeters. Weight is 2.2 grams, excluding the antenna. I did not weigh the transmitter with the cables and antenna attached before I put it on the little pod, but we'll take a look at that some more in a bit. And the contents, you get one video transmitter and one UFL antenna. That's another same thing as this little IPX connector as a micro FL. As far as the little diagram here, you see that's your antenna, your button for configuring the channels and bands and power output, your blue LEDs. You have 6 LEDs that's to indicate your which band you're on, and the red LEDs are your channels, and then these little red A and blue B, these little small LEDs here below, those are your power indicators. If I remember right, red is 25 milliwatts and blue is 200 milliwatts, and when they're both off, you have 0 milliwatts. But we'll take a look at that some more in a bit. As far as your wiring, start with the yellow wire here. You have video, your plus 5 volts out to your camera and ground, and then on the other connector, the other wire, like I said, this is separated out into 2 cables. The other ones, you have your ground and your power input, just 3.2 to 5.5 volts. So it is worth noting that running on 1S LiPo, 3.7 volt LiPo, or a 4.2 charge, but on a 1 cell LiPo, it will step that up and put 5 volts out to your camera, which is nice. If you open it up, you have kind of quick instructions on how to set things up. If you want to pause it, you can. You can read those instructions, and there's a diagram, a chart with all your different channels and bands. And that's pretty much it. And like I said, what I did, I took this and I set it up on this little backpack pod. It just has some Velcro in the bottom. And the little transmitter is just kind of stuck down with some double-sided tape there. Sorry, this doesn't want to focus. Give me a minute. So the transmitter is stuck down with some tape right there. You see I have this little kind of fin dual setup here to hold the antenna. And I have the Runcam Nano camera, which I have a couple of little wooden side pieces there. And it's just hot glued in there, so it's easily removed, and you can peel the glue off. If you ever want to remove it and use it somewhere else. What I did, I actually cut the cable for the video camera and I soldered it directly to the Nano just to take out one extra connector since I'm mounting it on here like this. And then this is your power input lead, and it comes with this tiny little connector which doesn't mate with any of my batteries, but it also came with this little adapter which plugs into that connector, this end. Focus. So this small end here will plug into the cable on the transmitter, and then this one matches with all my 1S LiPos that I use on my micro quads, which I happen to have one here now. One I just picked up is a little graphene 750 milliamp hour. While I haven't actually measured the current draw of the whole little pod here, including the camera, just going by the specs, even on the high power output on 200 milliwatts, the transmitter should pull about 600 milliamp hours or 600 milliamps. And this is a 750 milliamp hour battery, so allowing some overhead for your camera overall, I should get close to 1 hour, you know, just give or take about an hour runtime on a 1S LiPo, just powering a little pod. So that's pretty neat. If you want to use a smaller LiPo, you could do that. But another option is something like this little adjustable power regulator. You can buy these in a fixed 5 volt output, or this particular one here, it has a little potentiometer you can see right there, and that is to adjust the power output. And this is only step down, it doesn't step up, but you could run this on anything 2S or above and give a regulated 5 volts out to power the pod. And that this little regulator will handle, I believe it was either 1 amp or 2 amps, but either way you should be good to go with powering the pod from that. I'm just going to run it on a little 1S LiPo just to keep it simple, and some good clean power. And I'm actually going to mount this onto my Banzai FPV wing and make for a nice little small package. So let's go ahead and cut to that. I'll give you a look at that mounted on the airplane. Just give me 1 minute. All right, as you can see here, we have the Banzai little 600 millimeter FPV wing. Runs on a little single quad motor, quad ESC. If you haven't seen these yet, you've been under a rock somewhere. Everyone's built them and flown them. They're loads of fun. I think you can pick these up for about $30 or less. Throw a couple of servos, some leftover quad parts, and you're good to go. Now, I have flown this one FPV before. I actually had a 600 milliwatt transmitter on here, which was way overkill. And I used a Fox Air Mini Aero camera mounted up front, which is this little block of wood you see. But now I've removed that and stuck some Velcro on the front here to mate with the little pod. So I can actually mount the pod right onto the nose like so. That's it. That simple. And I will use this little included power adapter. Plug that in like so. Then I'll take my 1S LiPo, slide that under the little battery strap here, which used to hold the video transmitter in place. And now I'll plug power in and I'm good to go. I have a little FPV setup, little lens cap, and go fly. Now as far as the weight, this little pod, including the little balsa wood cradle, the transmitter, the antenna, the cables, the Runcam Nano, the whole pod, this little piece here. Basically everything you see here in my hand. This weighs 7 grams, which is not anything. Basically, there's not a lot of airplanes that won't fly it. Only, you know, maybe some of the smallest indoor airplanes, you know, you'll notice the weight on it, but I believe you could even fly it on that. And I'm sure there's some airplanes out there that couldn't handle 7 grams weight, but nothing I own can't handle it. So I'm going to fly it on the Banzai. The Banzai is nearly indestructible, especially lightweight like this. Run it off a little mini quad battery, micro quad, whatever. And just some good, cheap, fun flying. And I think this little transmitter, the Nano, I forget, I want to say it's around $19. I could be mistaken, but I will have a link to the Nano camera below this video. if you want to check it out. The transmitter here is, I want to say, $12 or $13. These little batteries are really cheap, about $7, $6, $7, something like that a piece. Like I said, you can pick these little voltage regulators up for a few dollars if you'd rather go that, and it actually save a little bit of weight. This would be lighter than a battery, quite a bit. So, and I'm just doing it like this to keep it simple and more portable, so I can Velcro this on other stuff too at some point. And I had these little quad batteries laying around, and they plugged in, so why not? Airplane kit's about $30, two servos, leftover quad parts. I mean, we're all up, we're probably well under $100. We're probably under $70. But, and then it's pretty much indestructible. It's light enough, it bounces off of stuff. So we're going to go fly and have some fun. And, I'll go ahead and leave you with that footage now. And if you want to check out any of this stuff, I'll put links to everything below the video. And, yeah, I mean, so enjoy. Alright, and first thing, I would like to apologize for the rather gloomy, dull day, the less than optimal conditions. Right now, this is pretty much the only chance I get to fly is between wind and rain showers, so I guess I'll take it. Now, on this first flight, we're flying at a 50 milliwatt setting for the power output, and I'm just kind of flying around and haven't flown the little wing in a while, so I'm just kind of getting a feel for it. Make a few laps around the field, and then I'm going to land and bump the power up to 200 milliwatts. I'm flying right now with an omnidirectional antenna, the Foxeer Pagoda Pro, on one receiver, and I'm going to land and set up the 200 milliwatt output power, as well as powering up my second receiver with a three-turn helical antenna, which is facing out over the fields, so I get a little bit more range if I want to fly out that way. Just it's there if you want to. All right, so now we're taking off again, and like I said, I have switched to the 200 milliwatt output power, and we're just gonna go and kind of fly around and get a feel for it. And once again, this is the RunCam Nano camera that I reviewed recently, had some flight footage up. I was flying it on the little micro indoor quad that I fly around the backyard sometimes, but I went ahead and pulled it off and put it on this little pod and put the little stock Isshin camera back on the micro quad. I like the RunCam camera. It's pretty decent. It's, you know, especially in these harsh lighting conditions, it's rather dull and heavily overcast and not really bright, and there's kind of a mist in the air. It's kind of foggy. But little camera does fairly well, you know, all things considered. But we're supposed to be focusing on the video transmitter here, and as you can see, it's working pretty well. There, you know, you do get some dropouts flying around behind the trees and behind the antennas, behind the trees and things like that, which is pretty much to be expected, especially on a low power 5.8 gigahertz video transmitter. And I'm also using the little stock dipole, little sleeve dipole that comes on it, in conjunction with the circular receiver antenna, so you do have some gain loss there with the polarity mismatch. But overall, it's working quite well. You can see here I kind of flew out a little ways. It's not terribly far, but for a micro wing like this, such a small wing with such a tiny little FPV pod on it, you know, I mean, I'm very happy with it, with the performance. And another thing I wanted to note, when I used the RunCam transmitter, the TX200, which is very similar to this one, it's switchable between 25 and 200 milliwatts. That one, while it does work equally as well as this one, it tends to run a lot hotter than the AKKTEK transmitter. The RunCam transmitter gets quite warm on 200 milliwatts, but I'm running this one on 200 now, and at the end of the flight, I noticed it was barely warm to the touch, but there's also a lot more airflow here than I was getting with a little micro quad just kind of hovering around the yard, flying relatively slow speeds. And it wasn't a very warm day today either, so I mean, those are some contributing factors, but it seems to run cooler than the RunCam transmitter did. And like I said, for such a little cheap
Transmitter, like I said, I think these run around $12 or $13, if I'm not mistaken. So far, it's, you know, I didn't really expect anything spectacular from it, but so far, I really don't have anything to complain about. So, I'm happy with it, and I think you would be too if you're looking for a transmitter as small as this one is. So, go ahead and check out the links below, and I hope this video helps you out. Thanks for watching. Keep an eye out for the next ones.